In a world where Athens is cursed by a ship with black sails that steals men and women, you will find the Minotaur.
Okay.
Pause! Despite what your reason may be telling you, this is not Bradley. This is a vicious man-eating Minotaur. Continue.
One time when the ship with black sails came, Theseus, the prince of Athens, joined the captives on the ship.
Pause! Despite what your perception tells you, this right here, this, that's a ship, okay? Continue.
Theseus set his eyes straight towards Crete, where all the prisoners were taken, having sworn to free his people from this dreaded curse. Once he got to Crete, Theseus asked to meet with Minos, the king.
Pause of many ways of knowing. It has emotion because Theseus is courage and brave. He is going to fight the curse that Crete has placed on his people by himself. Fear is one of the 6 primary emotions, and since it is a primary emotion, it is very difficult to overcome. Very few people have the ability to look fear in the eye and get rid of it. This has some limitations as well, because getting rid of one of your primary emotions makes you more apathetic. And if you are apathetic, then you really have no will to think and learn, and you have no ambition to try to gain knowledge. Fear causes you to learn a lot, as anyone who has ever experienced fear doesn't like it and therefore avoids whatever caused that feeling. Sometimes people even try to learn about what caused their fear, and through that, they gain knowledge. Play!
Battle the Minotaur myself. If I kill it, you set many people free. If I fail, then my companions will follow me to their death.
Tuh! The king's son wants to die? Psh! You will go tomorrow.
King Minos' own daughter, a wise and brave girl named Ariadne, saw the courage in Theseus' eyes and was inspired. She crept past her father's guards to help Theseus.
Here, take this. It will help you slay the Minotaur. And if you do slay the Minotaur, you're going to need a way out of the labyrinth. Here, take this gold thread.
It's Grand Yard.
No, it's not. It's gold thread.
It's Grand Yard.
It's gold thread.
Oh yeah, I forgot this is a no-budget movie. So I'm using reasoning to say that this is gold thread.
Obviously.
Yeah.
Anyways. Just tie it to a rock outside the labyrinth, and then you can follow it back out.
Why are you helping me? If your father finds out you did this, you'll be in great danger.
If I don't help you, you and your companions will be in even greater danger.
Pause! Also shows evidence of ways of knowing. It mainly shows reason. Ariadne reasons that by helping Theseus, she can also help all of his companions, as well as all of Athens. This shows inductive reasoning, because she is taking something particular, as in helping Theseus, and forming a more general conjecture based on that, as in helping all of Athens. This scene also shows emotion and language. Theseus has emotion in that he is courageous, and Ariadne picks up on that emotion through Theseus' body language. Without this body language conveying Theseus' emotion to Ariadne, she wouldn't have the courage to sneak past the guards and help Theseus. Theseus falls in love with Ariadne for her courage and bravery that led her to help him. This is another strong emotion that Theseus has. Love is by far the strongest emotion because most other emotions can be controlled. Happiness, sadness, anger, etc. can all be controlled to some extent, whereas love cannot be controlled. Love can be concealed, but if you truly love someone, there is no way you can just decide to stop loving them. Even with the best reasoning your mind can come up with, your emotions will prevail. This also shows that neither reason nor emotion is dominant. Emotion can give you answers when reason can't, but reason can keep your emotions from hurting you. They work together and yet separately.
The next day, Theseus was led into the labyrinth. As soon as he was shut inside, he tied one end of the string around a rock and set off into the labyrinth. He passed through narrow passages that were dark, damp, and cold.
Thank you.
Finally, he reached a room filled high with bones. He knew that he was getting close to the Minotaur. He heard a faint sound. Theseus picked up a handful of dirt and threw it right into its eyes. The Minotaur bellowed in pain and was blinded by the dirt.
Once again, this scene also demonstrates a lot of ways of knowing. It shows perception, because Theseus can't see very well when he is in the labyrinth, and he is forced to use other means of perception, such as touch and hearing. He hears the Minotaur before he sees it, and yet knows that it is the Minotaur that is roaring, because he reasons through the fact that the only other thing that is known to exist in the cave is the Minotaur, and so that is the only other thing that will make the sound. He also reasons that because he is near a big pile of bones, he is close to the Minotaur. This is deductive reasoning because he is taking general things, the sound and the bones, and deducing something specific, the Minotaur. He is a genius. This scene shows lack of language and communication between the Minotaur and Theseus, because the Minotaur doesn't speak the same language as Theseus, so there's no way to actually know what the Minotaur is thinking. He could be something like he has a thorn in his foot and it hurts really bad, but he can't get it out, so he eats people to ease the pain, and if that were the case, the solution would be simply take the thorn out. But since there is a lack of communication, Theseus assumes the Minotaur is just a bloodthirsty beast, because that is all he can make from the body language that the Minotaur shows him. Theseus also used reason to determine that throwing dirt in the Minotaur's eyes would blind it. He knew, probably from experience, that having dirt or some other small particle in your eye is quite painful and makes it hard to see. The Minotaur's loss of sight would be beneficial in the fight to come.